Hello, my amazing artists, back again this Wednesday. Today we're gonna be making a little neighborhood, and I think it's perfect for the weather today. Have you looked? It's raining, it's gross, we can't really play outside. Today, maybe even tomorrow. So I'm gonna want you to take things that you have around your house. You know Mrs. H loves doing that. We're gonna recycle things. These were the milk cartons that we got at school. So I have a bunch of these. Of course, I was going to recycle them, so I just cleaned them out. And then I'm going to show you how you can paint and draw on them. You can glue paper, whatever you want. I also have some other materials over here too, so come check it out. Okay, my amazing artists. So remember I said the milk cartons? Also, I know on my calendar it said paper bag, so I am going to be showing you how to make a little neighborhood out of a paper bag. So if you have a paper bag, grab that. Maybe you have a tissue box. Maybe you have just some little recycled dishes. This was from Chinese, my favorite food. I thought that would make like a perfect house. I also have this. This was left over from my kid's Easter, and he was shaped perfect like a little house. See, there's the side of the house. And then everybody loves Taco Bell. I saved this box because when I was looking at this, it looked to me like I could make a city building, like a skyscraper. You know how they're skinny and tall? So when I put it up to my house here, this building looks a lot bigger. So you're gonna need some fun recyclable stuff that you can make into houses, towns. Then some scissors, some glue, and crayons and markers. And we also need construction paper, guys. So, scissors, crayons, markers, glue, and construction paper. Mrs. H forgot that. All right, let's get started. All right, guys, so I'm gonna make this into a house first by using this paper. So instead of trying to paint it or use markers, I'm just going to trace it. I believe we've talked about this a lot. If I'm gonna trace, if I need to cover the sides of this, they're squares. So do I put it down in the middle of my paper and trace it? No, I don't. I'm gonna put it on the side in the corner so I'm not wasting paper. So put that down. Zoom. Go on the top. Zoom. Now I know that's one of my sides. Now I need another side traced. I'm gonna get the little triangular roof here. Oh, that's perfect. I can even do a third one. Then I'm gonna come right up here. I know I'm gonna need the back side. All right, you take your scissors. I'm gonna make this house the same color as mine. We have a gray house. So I thought this would be perfect. Ooh, you know what? You could almost just fold on the line and then go like that and glue that right on there. That's a great idea. Cut the other one. So you can do the triangles, like, or you can just cut the sides like this, however you wanna do. We're gonna take our glue stick. And seal that right on there. Boom. I'm gonna do this side. I'm gonna fold the other side so I don't get my marker lines right there. I don't like how that looks. So you can always just turn your paper back over. And the cool thing about this project, you guys, is I know that you're at home, you know, day after day, hour after hour. Just when your parents, when someone in your house has something, just say, hey, save some things for me. And you can make these anytime, and you can just keep adding on to your houses and buildings and make a whole neighborhood. You can add roads and trees. I'm gonna show you how you could do some trees.
Oh, guess I don't really need that one like that. I'm gonna cut this flat. You know I love toilet paper tubes, and that's a really good way. All right, let's trace here. We'll come right over here on this part of the paper. Ooh, but I don't want to color on my... I'm just gonna kind of make this shape up. Marley's taping my video and she said that she almost sneezed. Okay, so I think, well, I already covered four of my sides. I didn't need that one. Color, do I want my roof? Yeah, let's do my roof. Show you how to do that. So if you have construction paper, great. If not, you could always just use paint or Sharpie marker, that would work too. But I do have some. Oh, I love how this looks. So then when you take the paper and you put it over like this. Yeah, you can trim it up a little bit if you want. Let me fold it even first. Jeez, there we go. Okay. Oh, I like how that looks. Okay, so now I know I'm just gonna put a little glue right here. Because I can pinch it right there on that part. And you'll want to fiddle with it a little bit. Still need some glue right here and right here. Okay, so got this all glued and put together. I ended up pushing this in here, put that down on there. I'll show you how you can draw some things. But I want to show you how you could make trees. Take those toilet paper tubes, snip down just a little bit on either side. If you don't have green construction paper, just use regular paper and you could, I like how this looks too because then it looks textury. Color, 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 one direction. You're gonna wanna do it on the other side too. Then I'm gonna kind of cut this out to look like a silhouette of a tree. And then you can just slide it right in there. How else could this look like a tree?
Markings.
Markings, the bark. So take like a brown marker. And I believe we've all done lots of trees in class together. You know that I love to do trees. So add some bark in there so that it looks a little more realistic. You could, if you think, Mrs. H, that tree looks too big, you could experiment with cutting your toilet paper tubes down to make them smaller.
Maybe you see a bigger bush.
You could just use a bigger, oh, maybe you like how this looks here. There's so many different things you can do with your imagination and in these materials. But let me show you how I would start at my house. Draw light until you get it right. I would start with a pencil first and decide where you want the front of your house to be. Okay, going back to the paper bag one, this is what the front of my house looks like. So I have the door here, a little step. I have a flower pot here. We have some bricks. So I'm going to kind of show you, this is bothering me, so I'm gonna glue this really quick. Oh, also, before, or I drew everything on my paper bag house and then I tucked a plastic bag inside of there so that it's not flat. My glue isn't sticking that well, but that's a little better. That's my roof when I fold it down. So when I'm looking at my house, I'm gonna draw my door here. And get detailed with this. Get detailed with how your door really looks. I know it's raining out, but maybe you want to go outside and actually look at your door. Like, we have this glass piece here, our doorknob here. Got a little lock here. And then to make things look 3D, you could do these little lines coming out, and then do another line, and it makes it look kind of 3D. Got a step right here. I'm gonna switch over. My door is black. My door is black. So once I get it in pencil, and we can do these little lines, and this just makes it look a little 3D. Then I know, ooh, this is how you can make it look like a window, like it's a little bit of clear glass. Take like maybe like a blue color. You can kind of do these little marks like this. And it makes it look like it's kind of see-through glass. See how I can. Then I know that I have some brick down here. I'm gonna do my best to draw straight lines across, okay? And make the bricks look this. Alexa, skip this song. All right, so you can see how it's starting to come along. Now, in this one, I did a door and I added some green bushes right on there. That would look really nice with there. I also had fun with some superheroes and I added those and glued those on there. You guys can get as detailed as you want. These two I painted, so I'm able to just take, let me grab my Sharpies, just stay right here. So on that one, I'm able to take my Sharpies and draw right on here. And you can get a little more fine line there, okay? So there's lots of ways that you guys can do this. The paper bag, I think, coloring it with crayon or marker would be best. I drew all these on there. And that's a blue frame. Let me find my color that I need. You know what I was also thinking is that we could add roads and grounds. Maybe you have a box that you want to set all of this in. And you could add a base, a ground, and start building your town and putting houses next to each other. I'll show you what I mean here in a minute. So I would take my time to color this. Remember I said this was like a flower basket. So wanna add some flowers. All right, I'm gonna work on this for a little bit and then I'll get back to you guys. Oh wait, before I go. Remember I said this would be a good city box. A building, skyscraper building. So on the side here, they always have lots of windows. So you could add so many windows and get so detailed with what you're drawing inside each of those windows. And I'll have a big door down here. Whoa, might have to tape that so it doesn't come apart. And then maybe you wanna just draw some trees right on here. These are gonna be some trees next to the building. tree. Remember, we took the blue. You can either make these windows look empty and just have like little blue reflections, or you can draw things inside of there. I'm definitely gonna have to take a little strip of glue right here though, because this box wants to keep coming apart. Okay. All right, guys, so I'm gonna work on this for a little bit. I'm gonna try to find another box and show you how you can set your neighborhood, your city, your buildings, your houses, set all of those things up, okay? Be right back. All right, guys, so I had a little coffee and had a good idea. Remember how I was showing you this box to make it into a building? Well, then I said, what if I made this an art museum, and instead of closing it up, we could open it and make this a whole little art museum inside, and we could put paintings and your own work. I'm gonna make a little red carpet here. Can you guess who this is? Show me the Mona. So here she is, and here's her little red carpet that you would walk up to. So I don't know, I'm gonna experiment and play with this a little bit more and add things, and then in another video, show you guys. I just thought that would be kind of a neat addition. Also, maybe in my neighborhood, I'm gonna have a hair salon there. Here's another house. Still working on the paper bag house. Remember, I showed you some other things and I said I was gonna talk about adding this all in a box. Maybe you have a lid or something that you can add these things to. So I thought about, I went in my garage and I looked and I have this. So I thought, how cool would it be if I just added all of my things maybe right inside of here? Put my tree there. Put my hair salon back there. I saved this. I thought this would be a great, I'm obviously gonna need to color it more, but can you tell what this is gonna be at my house? Like if I color this in really nice and it's all blue, it's gonna look like a pool, right? So that could be my pool at my house. Maybe these guys are neighbors and they have a pool in the backyard. And then on the actual box, I thought, okay, I can already see how this is turning out. Maybe this is gonna become, this part of the box is the grass. So I would color this all in very nice. And here in a couple weeks, in my May calendar, I have another sculpture Sunday where you're supposed to build, and I will show you guys how my sculpture neighborhood is coming along. And then this was perfect for the road, right? So this side could be the houses and the grass, and then maybe over here I'm gonna have some businesses where I could go to. So I hope you guys really enjoyed making neighborhood sculptures with me. It was really fun. See ya. All right, my amazing artists. So here's just a little preview of what I did during my break. Colored that in with Sharpie, added some water, then I even put some Apple Jacks for some floaties. So got my road there. There's gonna be my art museum. There's a tree. Gonna have some other businesses here. And then across the street, I'll do my neighborhood with the houses. So as you can see, I just used things that I had around our house. I hope you guys can get creative and enjoy that, because blah, blah, blah. It's a rainy day. Perfect day to stay inside over the next couple days. Take what you have and build and make some things. I love and miss you guys so much. I hope you're enjoying these videos. And I'm also going to show you a quick video on how to shrink some plastic cups down. So I hope you'll tune into that too.